Welcome to the CAD Office Training Guide Series for FDOTConnect. I am Joel Gutierrez, Structural Engineer at WSP USA. Today I will be going through the Open Bridge Modeler Training Volume 1, Introduction to Model-Centric Design. In this series of videos, we will take you step by step through each exercise from the guide. In this session, we will continue to go through Chapter 6, Plans Development, and finish up Exercise 6.1. The topics covered in this video include a further background into the plans development aspects of Open Bridge Modeler. However, we will now be taking a look at the superstructure components and learn how to create a typical section sheet. Let's begin. So in our last video, we saw how we can use Open Bridge Modeler to create drawings with different views of substructure components, specifically a pile bent. You can still see that we have our saved view from our previous video around the pile bent. In this video, we're going to continue learning how to create these drawings, but this time we're going to take a look at the superstructure and see what tools we need to use so we can cut a typical section of our superstructure. So much like we did in the start of the last video, we created a sheet file, a separate sheet file, so we can work with our drawing in a separate file from our design file. So we're going to navigate up to the FDOT tab and over to the Actions group, where we'll create a file. So the only thing different about this process is instead of using the substructure sheets file group, we're going to be navigating to the superstructure sheets file group. And then we'll scroll all the way down to the base file name for the typical section through a bridge deck. So we'll select that one and make sure we have our have it at 01 for our first sheet. And then we'll make sure that we have the right output folder, which is structures. All right, so we'll create the file, and that'll open up the separate sheet file that we are going to be making our drawing in. So once we get that set up, we can go back to our original file. So we'll go to open and back to the exercise file. Okay, so now that we have our design file open back up, we can start with the process of making our typical section. We don't really need to access the settings as much as we did for the previous exercise, as that's more geared towards the substructure components. However, we can just verify that we have the correct dimension style, which is the structure's line leader, and the correct title text style name. So we do have those both correct. We don't need any of the different views as we're only cutting a section. This won't affect anything because this is just for any kind of substructure. And then additionally, the clip's not going to affect anything as we don't have any piles or columns that need clipping. So whether it's clicked on or off, it won't affect it. We'll accept that. So once we're satisfied with our text and dimension styles, we can start the process of actually creating our typical section drawing. For that, we can remain in the Analysis and Reporting tab and go over to the Drawings group. And there you'll find the Create tool that allows us to create a cross-section drawing. So we'll click that, and then we'll be prompted to select the alignment we want our section cut along. So obviously, since we're cutting a typical section of our bridge, we want to make sure that we're selecting the alignment our bridges run along. So we will go ahead and click the PGL left. Now you'll notice that there's a blue perpendicular line that pops up emanating from the PGL as the location that our section is cut at. So we can either select a location just by going along the alignment and just clicking a point, or we also have the option of choosing a specific location by selecting or turning this check on for the station. And then we can enter in whatever specific station we have in mind. So you'll notice that now that it has this 664.28, I cannot move anywhere along this other than that point. So the second I select, it'll just have a section cut at that point. I mean, that can be useful if you have a specific location in mind. You want to show a specific type of super elevation that we have in a varying location like we have now, or we have if we have a variable beam spacing and you want to show one location's beam spacing, that can be useful in that sense. But for this instance, we're not going to select a specific station. We're going to opt to just go along the alignment ourselves. Okay, so another thing to note is that these little orange X's here, that will be the limits of our section. So we want to make sure, first of all, that whenever we choose a location, we remain outside of our bridge limits. We're always going to make sure that the X to the right of the bridge and the X to the left of the bridge are both outside the bridge limits. Otherwise, you'll have an incomplete cross-section. Another thing to note, it may be difficult to see, but there is a line or an arrow that is pointing down station currently, right at the alignment. So if we keep our cursor to the right of our bridge, that will cut a section that is facing down station, as it's shown here. Now if we move our cursor to the left of the bridge, you'll notice that the arrow switches direction. That will now cut a section in the other direction, facing up station. So for our drawing, we want to show it down station, so we'll go to the right of the bridge, and then we'll make sure that our X's are just outside the bridge limits and click near midspan. Okay, so this is a familiar box that pops up. This is similar to what we had in the last video where we were making our pile bent sheet. We'll go through this a very similar process. So we'll set the seed, the drawing seed, to FDOTSection. And then we want to make sure that both our drawing model and our sheet model are being created. So we have both of those toggled on. We'll make sure that we have our models being sent to the correct sheet file that we created earlier. So we'll make sure that that's correct and that this is correct. Make sure we're in our structures folder and our typical section. Okay, and then we can set our scales. And we can go ahead and just name this typical section. Okay, and now that we're ready to go, we can just click OK. That'll open up our sheet file. Okay. So you may have an issue where, even though we said not to use the auto dimensioning, if there's testing going on with the FDOT workspace, we may have some auto dimensioning pop up. For the sake of this exercise, I'm going to remove those and we'll go through the manual. We'll go through our manual dimensioning just to get some practice. So now that our drawing model and our sheet model have both been created and sent to the typical section sheet file that we made earlier, you'll notice that the typical section name we gave our sheet model and our drawing model in this step before this is now shown in our active groups drop-down list. Okay, so before we start dimensioning or anything, we want to make sure that we have our drawing within that we have our section within our sheet border. So to do that, we can't just move anything. As we know, this is when we're in this sheet model, this is going to be a reference of our drawing model. So we're going to have to go to our references, and there we can make sure we're selecting our typical section drawing model reference, and we'll just go ahead and move that so that it's within our border. As such. Okay. And now we can start the annotation aspect of the drawing. So as was mentioned in our previous video, you can do that in either the sheet model or the drawing model, but recommends that we do it in our drawing model. So we'll proceed with that. Okay, so as we did in our last video, we'll just get a little more practice doing our dimensioning. To do that, we need to navigate over to our drawing workflow, and then we're going to go to the Annotate tab and use the Dimension Linear tool. Okay, and we want to make sure that we're using our correct dimensioning, which we have here. And then now we can just start all of the dimensions that are shown in our exercise 6.1. So one of the main ones is the full width of the bridge. As well as the barrier width and our gutter to gutter width. So I will, because there's a lot of dimensioning to go through, I'll skip ahead here. You can go ahead and pause to finish your dimensioning, but just really quick before that, you'll notice that you won't be able to snap to the PGL. So for that dimension from the gutter line to the PGL, we know from our design model that our left gutter is 22 feet from our PGL. So we'll just create a construction line at that location and then dimension to there. I'll touch on creating construction line in the next segment, as well as show you the finished product. So. Okay, so here is our finished dimensioning. before we move any further, let's make sure that our section view title is centered in our section here. So we can select that, move up to the Home tab within our drawing workflow, and go over to the Manipulate group, where we'll just select Move. And just slightly move it over. So now we're a little more centered within our view here. One thing to point out is that when we're in this drawing workflow, the drawing model operates a lot like our a regular 2D CAD drawing. So you have the option to place lines and modify anything that you want to modify. It acts very similar to how MicroStation would have in the past. So if for whatever reason we want to draw a line from our PGL 10 feet, we can just draw it over as a construction line. If you need to place a dimension or anything like that, you can run it to there and then just delete this construction line. Notice that you can change anything that is created in the drawing model, but you can't change anything that is from the design model. So I can't delete this or delete the deck or delete the beams or anything like that. That can only be done by turning off the level, as previously demonstrated in our previous video. Okay. So now that we're done dimensioning and setting up our annotations, we can navigate back to our sheet model. So we'll go to our active view group, goal section sheet model. So now we have our finished product. We can move, if we want, we can move the scale within the view of the sheet border as well. So, okay. Thank you for joining me today for the CAD Office series for FDOTConnect. This was the end of exercise 6.1 for the OBM Intro to Model-Centric Design Guide. In the next video, we will work on exercise 6.2 and learn how to create different section views using a different tool called Dynamic View by Station.